Hello, friends. Once more into the abyss we go. Sorry to repeat my awesome intro. I had to adjust a setting real quick. Hi, everyone. This is Abyss Odyssey. Let me sync up the chat. I have to alt-tab out, which stops the sound. Alright. That book, the seal on that book, is the Warlock's Mask, and you can see how it was, like, half-broken. Crap. I hit enter with the keyboard instead of the controller. Hopefully, the game doesn't think I want to use the keyboard. Controller seems to be working so far. So that mask, you notice it was half-destroyed on the cover of that book. Hello to Kasia and Lord Tamar in the chat room. What that means is that, enough people, the more people win this game, the more players defeat the Warlock in this game, the more that seal breaks. And once that seal is completely broken, then supposedly, they'll add more content into the game, or more content will unlock, or something like that. It's like a community goal. And I'm not sure exactly what that's going to entail. It'll be interesting to see what happens. They might have a slight problem. Well, in my case, I have a slight problem. Because it still says I've defeated the Warlock 0 times, and I've beaten him at least 3 times now. So, it's going to take a while for that goal to be achieved if a lot of people are having the same issue I am. I had a pretty good run last night. I made it to the Warlock. Or Monday night, rather, with the Ghost Monk. Tonight, I think I will play as the starting character, Katrien. And my goal for this playthrough is to get the achievement for capturing a level 40 monster. And as far as I know, there are only 3 level 40 or above monsters in this game. And they're all, like, relatively huge bosses. So it'll be interesting to see if I can pull this off. I'm going to prepare this time. I did not prepare very well before I went in on Monday. So I'll buy the best sword you can buy on the surface. You can't buy any magic weapons or anything. Just this Spanish rapier, which does 16 damage instead of 10. Play as the Naked Lady Duke. Well, as much as I like her mechanics, like the way she fights is really cool. It does creep me out a little bit, because, I don't know, it just seems really gratuitous and unnecessary. Like, she's in this real gross pose, and I don't know. It's not the sort of thing. Ten coins? That's a pretty good deal. So yeah, I'll play as Katrien for now. So I'm going to head to the cathedral, which is where you will find the monster shop. I didn't even know about this guy, because for some reason it didn't occur to me that the scaffolding was something you could climb. I thought it was just like scenery. And I watched a stream of someone playing this game, and I found out this guy was here. And I'm going to buy the soul of a wood golem, which is probably my favorite monster in this game. Now you got me even more interested in seeing her. Well, I mean, it's like, it's very stylized, like, stylized nudity. I mean, she looks like a Barbie doll, really, more than an actual person. It's not really, like, her face is, like, normal Caucasian flesh colored, but the rest of her body is, like, pale, and, like, I think she's supposed to be, like, part mermaid or something, except she has legs, but I don't know. Like, it's a little uncanny valley for me, to be honest. What do you have to say, Father? Oh, thank you. I'm sure that will come in handy. God bless. Yeah. So I don't know which column the boss is going to be in. There are 3 areas you can start the dungeon in, and you have to unlock them as you play. I have all 3 of them unlocked. And the far right column, it's shorter to get to the boss, but it's also a much harder path. So, let's bring out the wood golem. Oh, great. Let's bring out the wood golem and then get trapped between these guys and the buzzsaw. The wood golem is awesome. He has really powerful attacks. I mean, he's super slow, of course, but he can break the enemy's guards pretty easily, and he's really good, in theory, for handling these situations where you get kind of ganged up on. I'm not doing very well so far though. Like that move. Alright, well, that was a little rough, but I suppose it could have gone worse. Wood Golem also has a lot of life, which is pretty nice. Switch to Catrian just to try to get in there without getting hit by the buzzsaw. I like how the Wood Golem is so huge that eclipse through some of the environments. Buzzsaw would be effective against everything. Yeah, especially wood though. Like in Mega Man 2, I believe the Metal Blade is pretty effective against Woodman. Of course, like you were saying, the Metal Blade is pretty effective against everything in that game. Unfortunately, there's nowhere to buy potions or anything on the surface. There's a camp token store where I could buy a camp token to place at one of the altars later in the game, which I probably should have bought one of those, as well as the sword and the monster. But I didn't really consider that. That store is in the middle area. The second area you unlock. Oh, come on, stop blocking. Baby. Blocking's for noobs. Didn't you know that? So I would like to be the warlock in this playthrough, if possible. That's another of my ultimate. Oh, what? Aw, man, that fish just came out of nowhere. So did that one. So yeah, beating the warlock would be nice, but mostly I'm trying to get that sweet, sweet achievement. Of course, I'm only level 37, which means I'm going to have to go up a few levels before I attempt to capture a high-level enemy. And that's a sword for the ghost monk that I cannot use. So let's take a look at the map here. Oh, and of course, the boss is in the first column, and I'm not going to have any way to get there. Well, that sucks. You can look at the map before you decide which path to choose, but the boss icon doesn't show up on the map. You don't know where the boss is going to appear until you go into the actual dungeon. So not only do I have the hardest path, I don't have a chance to fight that boss. So, I'm not going to get the achievement in this playthrough, it looks like. Unless, if I can reach level 45, there's a level 45 enemy, you jerk, that spawns occasionally when you enter an area on the surface. Like, I don't know if there's a trick to getting him to spawn or anything. I've only fought him a few times. He's a big, huge lion type creature. I don't even know how to describe him. He's like a giant lion who's covered with eyeballs. Oh, is that the gold ring? No, that's fire resistance. Oh well. That's still okay. And the enemy's called the living creature. So if I can hit level 45 and I'm lucky enough to have the living creature spawn, I might be able to get the achievement that way. I've actually tried for this achievement twice now, fighting the boss. I guess, oh you jerk. Man, slow characters are not very good on ice. But the first time I defeated the boss and tried to capture him, for some reason, his soul didn't drop. I don't know if it was a glitch. I mean, I should have been a high enough level to get him. But, yeah, hopefully that won't happen the next time. Next time I attempt that. And the second time, I missed with the big AoE attack entirely. Like, I launched it, and the boss I'm referring to is, like, a king. If any of you are familiar with this game, that's the boss that I mean. Alright, I have a skill point to apply. I'm going to apply it to this ability, and I'm actually going to switch this out. I tried using this for a little while, and I don't really like it, so I'm going to switch back to this one. It occurred to me that I haven't really shown off Katrien's abilities yet. So she has, well, right now what I have equipped is, this is neutral attack, forward attack, up attack, down attack, neutral special, I like that one, down special, and my up special that I just switched to is Infinite Swords. That's a fun one. What you got for me, Shotkeep? Health file? I will take that off your hands. Freeze resistance. Charm time. If I had a charm sword, that would be good. I could get a level 3 flame sword for 23,000. Yeah, see, stuff is much more expensive. Now that I'm a higher level. In my Ghost Monk playthrough, all of the stuff was way cheaper. So, nothing else you want, so I will go ahead and fight the Shopkeeper. Crap. Tried to dodge out of the way before he could hit me. He always has, like, a, kind of, the initiative when you select choose Shopkeeper. Or fight Shopkeeper, rather. Maybe I should capture this guy. Shockkeeper's not bad. He's not my favorite enemy to have, but he's okay. The computer uses him a lot more effectively than I can. Hey! Oh my god. Jesus Christ. No, don't fall down there. Told him not to fall down there. The spinning attack looks really silly, like she's dancing or something. Yeah, it's not very effective. Oh no! Not a very effective attack. Maybe, this is going very poorly for me. I'm not going to have a chance to fight the boss in this playthrough. I started off in the absolute wrong path. I'm going to cut my losses and start over. I know that's not very sporting of me, but this is a tough game. I kind of need every advantage I can get. So I wasted a good bit of money in my preparations since I ended up starting over, but I still have a pretty good bit of money as well. So I'm going to hit enemies with sharp blades, but you never cut them. It reminds me of one silly PS1 sword fighting game. No one ever gets cut slash chopped there. Yeah, well, I guess it's... a lot of work to animate, like, actual realistic cutting physics. Alright, so this is a guy who sells the camp tokens. I'm gonna go ahead and buy one of these. They're also a lot cheaper than if you buy them in the actual dungeon. So, I'm going to buy the best one I can get for right now. I was kind of worried that the living creature would spawn before I was ready to fight him, because from what the forums say, he's more likely to spawn in Pokuro Park than in either of the other two locations. But luckily he didn't spawn. I'm okay with fighting him. I've killed him before, but I'd like to have full mana before the fight begins, just so if I do beat him, I have a chance of capturing him. Alright, so I want to go with Wood Golem again. I died pretty quickly. But then again, I did start off in the most difficult branch. I've unlocked most of the enemies in this game. There's a nightmare form of the three main characters, and I've got two of them, Catrian and the Monk. I still need the nightmare form of Pinkoya. I need the two, well, I need the three big bosses, obviously. And I think there are a couple of the cow creatures that I still need. Like, I have this guy, and I have the golden calf, but I think there's at least one more cow creature I need. Yeah, I want to go Wood Golem. I just like that guy too much. So I'm going to start off in the Santa Lucia Plaza path, and hopefully I'll have a way to get to the mid boss by taking this path. By the way, if you're starting out, make sure you jump over here because there's a special move to pick up that I did not discover right off the bat. Alright, I feel like I'm more prepared, and I'm taking an easier starting path. Honestly, I probably could have salvaged that last run. I had two more healing potions, so I probably could have done something with that, but I just felt like it was a really bad start. Alright, let's check over here first and see if, I really love that move. I'm a big fan of moves in fighting games that hit a lot of times in a short period of time. Oh hey, there's a reason to come over here. Nice. What you got for me? Nothing I need. Alright, I'm actually not going to fight the shopkeeper this time because I'm level 38. I'm pretty close to hitting 40. And the shopkeeper kind of kicked my ass the last time. So I'm going to, give myself every advantage I can to try to... I want to try to be the warlock on this run. I don't know why I was trying to break that. I care so little about the antidotes. I thought it was my mind interpreted it as one of the vases. I mean, it's not that the antidote's useless, it's just that by the time I remember to use it, whatever status effect I have has already worn off. And, you know, compared to the other two potions, it is useless. Come on, what you gonna do? You wanna be like that, huh? I need to go back to the starting screen after this and see how many enemies I still actually need to capture. Because if you go to the training screen, it shows you every enemy you've unlocked so far. And it has a question mark for any enemy that you haven't unlocked yet. Curse resistance? Sure, I'll take it. Is that a special wall? Nope. And the last time I checked, there were quite a few question marks, but I've captured a couple new enemies since then, so I need to double check that. I really like the sliding kick move because it can be done in midair like that, which is a really effective way to combo it into some other moves. Hey, I actually remembered to use my antidote. What do you know? I don't know why sometimes the barrier just kind of goes away on its own. Normally the barrier stays until all the enemies in that section are killed. Sometimes the barrier just kind of disappears. Should probably be using the wood golem, huh? I have full mana now, which is nice. Once the wood golem dies, I can immediately capture something new. I will have to make sure I have enough mana by the time I get to the king, though. Forget that boss's actual name. It's something Dei. D-E-I, which is Latin for king. Alright, what's the map looking like? Okay. Alright, this is good. So I have an arena, four rooms down, then one more, and then I can go right, then I have the City of Gold and the boss. That'll work out pretty well for me. Hey, buddy.
Am I cursed? I saw it coming for me. A skull covered in flames. You continue. Please take this and make good use of it.
Dude, I feel you. Those flame skulls are a thorn in my side. They did way more damage to me than they should have in my playthrough on Monday. Alright, I have a hard area, but this should be okay. It's just one. And then things will get a little easier after that. Let's see, some treasure down here. I bet there's an enemy too. No? Oh, I don't have a key though. Oh, hey. That's a large one too. Nice. You don't see large health vials laying around like that very often. Aw, man. Dude has a cursed weapon. The other guy has a fire weapon. Oh no. Okay, that was a little cheesy, but it got results. Oh hey, it's this guy. This guy shows up every once in a while. Not sure if there's something that triggers him or if it's just kind of a random event. But mostly what he does is he just floats around and throws curse orbs at you. He has a couple other attacks, I think, but you don't see them very often. This is the only enemy in the game that you cannot capture. Every other enemy and every other boss can be captured, but not that guy. Which, I mean, I guess it makes sense, because if you could play an enemy that could float around like that, then, I don't know, it might be advantageous. Might be easier to dodge attacks or something. Oh, hey, what's up, Just Drop? Long time to see. Duke is a tree. Yes, I am a wood golem. And the wood golem's almost dead, but that's okay. Because I have a full mana bar, and I am ready to use it. Alright, moderate and then three easies. Nice. Don't want to use my camp token just yet. I'm not deep enough into the dungeon yet. I've read one article that mentions one non-obvious reason why... Oops, I, sorry, Koss, your message scrolled away. non-obvious reason why roguelikes became so popular, a small dev team can create hundreds of hours of gameplay by making their game procedurally generated. Yeah, that's definitely a plus. I mean, the obvious example for me would be the original Spelunky, the Game Maker version, which was made by one person, and I mean, it's basically, I mean, the HD remake is like a graphical overhaul, and it adds a few things, but it's essentially the same as the original version. You are a jerk, sir. I really need to start blocking more. I tend to stick to dodges more than, and don't use blocks that much. But I need, oh man, this guy again? You gotta be kidding me. You just won't leave me alone, will you? Maybe I can trick him into being stuck on that blade trap. Nah, probably not. Also, this guy can go through walls, which would be a, might be a little broken if you could play as this guy. Someone suggested in the forums that this guy is like the ghost in Spelunky, and he shows up when you spend too long on a single level. That doesn't seem to be the case. I spend way longer on levels than this without him showing up before. It just seems to be, just a random event, and he only gives you 20 experience points. But if you don't kill him, he will follow you, as I learned the hard way. Oh no, I did not see that spike trap. Come on. I could use my health potion to heal the wood golem, but I don't know. I'd rather hold on to the health potions for when I really desperately need them. Wouldn't let me cheese him that time. I think the only reason it let me cheese him that one time was because he was on a slightly higher level than me, like physical level, since he was on the ground that time. Large health file, don't mind if I do. 20% experience gained, don't really need it. 15% chance when hit to charm an enemy for 20 seconds. Charming is pretty nice. I don't like items that do things when you get hit, though. I could also buy a sword of charm for only 8,000. I think I'll stick with the fire sword. Have I gotten any skill points or anything? No. Okay. Alright, switch back to Catrian to make it easier to climb up here. Wood Golem is not much longer for this world. Actually, I should probably be Catrian for this part too. Alright, time to go out in a blaze of glory, Wood Golem. Or you could just wreck people. That's a good option, too. Golem on golem action. Okay. That wall looks suspicious, but it was just a wall. Man. I am really surprised I'm not dead yet. I've had double-digit hit points for... Well. Man, this sucks. That's not an instant kill, by the way, when you fall down there. It's just, it does 200... Yeah, I'm not going to worry about that antidote. It does 200 points of damage and then puts you back on solid land. Aw, man, if I had an ice sword, I could break my way in here. But I do not. You don't see wood golems in games too often. Yeah, it's true. Golems in general have kind of gone by the wayside. There we go. I could capture these guys, but the undead soldiers really aren't that great. I'd rather save it for a jackal or a golem. Wood or stone, really. The stone golem is also pretty good, but I prefer the wood golem. 39, nice. What you got for me, old man? My sayings give wisdom to some. I'll listen. Finding the bad in others does not make yourself good. Yep, so I've heard. 60 XP. Alright, going back into some easy levels for a little while. It'll give me a chance to, hopefully shore up my defenses a little bit. Large health file, I will always take one of those. Oh, my inventory's full. Let's see, I could drop this antidote or use one of my health vials, or I could put a camp token here. But it still seems a little early for a camp token. I'll just drop that. Do I want it? Ooh, I can get plus 25% burn damage. For only 2300 gold? I think that's a good investment. Paganini was an actual person. Yeah, I was going to mention that if I encounter Paganini again. I looked him up, and it turns out that he was a real Italian violinist. And He was such a virtuoso violin player that like there were rumors that he made a deal with the devil for his violin skills, and that they made movies about him and stuff. All right, like there was a movie called I think The Magic Bow about Paganini. Where he had like some sort of, I mean I don't know anything about it, I just saw the title, but I assume it is about his dealings with the devil to get a bow that would enable him to play the violin at superhuman levels. Like supposedly, I mean it was back in like the days when, let me talk to this guy.
This is the end for me. Please keep this safe. Better than letting the enemy find it. What will happen to my soul in this place? Promise you'll slay that monster.
Well, I can't promise, but I promise to try. But yeah, being accused of making a deal with the devil was taken pretty seriously back then. I think like he was refused a Catholic burial because of this rumor, at least according to Wikipedia. And I know Wikipedia cannot always be trusted. But I tend to have good results with it. Alright, I can be bird person or I can be stone golem. I think that's a pretty easy choice. So Stone Golem has this crazy long wind-up attack, but if it actually hits, it does like a billion points of damage. And he also has like kind of a sidewinder uppercut, and he can throw rocks at people. And he can also punch really, really hard. And he has 2,500 hit points, which is pretty good. Sucks to live back then. Yeah, you're telling me. All someone has to do is insinuate that you made some sort of demonic pact and it can mess up your life. I like the stone golem. I might like him as much as the wood golem. He just plays very differently. He doesn't have like the rolling charging attacks. Also, I don't like how one of his arms is like half of a human arm. It's kind of creepy. It's like he has one shriveled, desiccated arm and one... Harbinger of Destruction. Dang it. Dang it. That was not a good time to try a wind-up attack. Luckily, I already have the Ghost Monk in my Pokédex, so I don't feel bad about wasting the mana on the Stone Golem. You jerk. Yeah, when you don't wind it up all the way, you don't get the ridiculous knockback. I should have kept blocking. Whereas the bad thing about the golems is that they are incredibly slow. And I mean, the monk isn't the fastest enemy in the world, but he still has a leg up on the stone golem as far as dexterity goes. Okay, we have an arena next, so hopefully I can be successful and heal up a little bit. I don't know if it heals just me or me and the enemy I'm using. He's wrecking you. Yeah, he did kind of wreck me. Aw, man, this guy. Bird person is okay, but not my favorite. Of course, this is an easy level, so hopefully I'll have that going for me. And neither of these enemies are particularly frightening. And the mummy's a little scary. Is it a fire mummy or the vomit mummy? Looks like the fire mummy. Nope, it's the vomit mummy. I would prefer to fight the fire mummy, but I should be able to handle this. Alright, well, that went extremely well. Alright, heal both of us. That is very nice. That would have been worth it even if I had to use a health potion to get through that. But I did not. Alright, feel very good about my situation right now. I have 3 health potions and 2 characters with almost full health. I could have said full health, but except I just got hit by a caterpillar. The enemies aren't the smartest in the world in this game, by the way. As you can tell, by the way, that golem just walked right into my fist of death. Oh man! I almost got both of them with like a very, very powerful attack. Oh well. I don't like the range this bird dude has with that spear. I guess I should call it the peacock dude to differentiate him from the other bird person. Which I think the other one is a lady, but but I can't be sure. Makes me think of an old fighter called Eternal Champions. Was that that was a Genesis game, wasn't it? Maybe I might be thinking of something different. Yeah, I mean, this game is very much a beat-em-up, sort of, but I like it more than other beat-em-ups because the combat mechanics are pretty interesting. Of course, my only experience with beat-em-ups are, like, the ones that are bad, like Golden Axe on the Genesis. So your mileage may vary with beat-em-ups. Oh, I don't like you. The fact that you can be comboed to death is terrible. In this game or in Eternal Champions? Cause yeah, if the enemies can get you cornered or trapped between two of them, then yeah, they can combo you and they can be pretty bad. You jerk. Especially if you're playing on Nightmare Mode, which I haven't even attempted Nightmare Mode yet. Inventory full. Well, let's see, I don't want to drop my camp token, so I guess I will use one of these health vials. So I can pick this one up. I thought people liked Golden Axe. No, never played it though. I mean, I liked it when I was a kid because I didn't know any better. But trying to go back to it now, that game is not very good. Like, in this game, I very clearly got better at it the more I played. Like, I learned how the combat worked, and I mean, I'm not like the world's best Abyss Odyssey player or anything, but like, I can hold my own, I know what I'm doing. Whereas in Golden Axe, like, as much as I played it, I don't know how to be good at that game. He has a point, I guess. So yeah, Golden Axe, not a great game. I mean, it was based on an arcade game, and arcade games are designed to get as many quarters out of you as possible. So I guess basically I just don't like games based on arcade games. If you want to win at Golden Axe, learn how to time your jump kick. Yeah, I ended up playing as the Valkyrie. I think that was the name of that character. And just jump kicking enemies to death over and over again. But I still couldn't beat it without... I think I made it to the final boss a few times before I ran out of continues. But I could never beat that final boss because he had skeletons that infinitely... or skeletons that you couldn't kill. They constantly attacked you while you were trying to fight the boss, and it was just a disaster. Burn immunity? Nah. I guess I can go ahead and use a camp token here. And I could buy another one, but they're ridiculously expensive this far down. I should do a no damage run of Golden Axe. I would be very impressed by that. Like, I would actually like to see that. I like how if you switch forms while you're standing on that platform, you just kind of phase through it. I think I could play Golden Axe for the rest of my life. Like 10 hours a day until the day I die, and I couldn't beat that game without taking any damage.
don't have much time left. I felt confident I could slay those half-bird witches. But I fought one too many. I may serve a purpose still. Take this treasure.
Kinda sucks that all he gave me was gold. Occasionally those guys will give you a camp token. And it seems like they give you health potions pretty often. But they give you gold just as often. I did it once and also did double dragon and contra. Wow. That is that's something I'd like to see. Of course, I guess Contra would just be a matter of playing it over and over again and memorizing it. Now that seems more doable to me than Golden Axe does, because it's not like all you have to do is memorize where the enemies are. Like you actually have to like do well against the enemies. But yeah, I could see someone doing a no damage run of like Contra or Ninja Gaiden or something, because that would just be, you know, running it over and over and over again. Basically the same as like speedrunning it. Ooh, mirror necklace, nice. 18% chance of reflecting, 100% damage received. I will take that. That is a very good item. I never really played Double Dragon, so I'm not sure how difficult that would be. That was another side-scrolling beat-em-up, right? I really like that wind-up punch. That's very satisfying to use. All of the combat is pretty satisfying in this game. Like, the way hits connect, there's like just the right amount of pause to like make it feel like an achievement. I'm not sure how you open up these barriers. Like, I'm pretty sure I was able to open one up with a fire sword before. I thought it was just any magic weapon, but this doesn't seem to be opening. But yeah, there's like a little bit of a pause, like it makes a really solid thunk noise. Aw man, I don't really like playing as the fire mummy very much. I like the regular mummy, the one with the poison vomit attack. But these guys, I don't know. I don't like very many of the projectile attacks in this game. That just seems like way too easy for the enemies to dodge. What else do I have? Oh yeah, I have like the fire trap. Hey, you're not supposed to be able to jump up there. This guy is pretty fast though, which is nice. I might have to use a potion to get through this. Which would be, it'd be worth it if I could make it through this using only one potion. Because my stone golem would be healed all the way. And I don't think Catrian has any damage on her, but if she does, she would be healed all the way as well. Okay, I want to go ahead and use one actually. Oof, that one might not be enough. Crap! Duke should show NetHack someday. I really love NetHack. I don't know how entertaining it would be to watch. Well, at least Catrian didn't take any damage from that. I think feeling those stages is supposed to damage you. I'm not sure. I thought there was some penalty for failing. But I don't remember. It seemed I don't know if the stone golem had that much health before I started that stage or not. Poison damage? Eh. Like, NetHack, it would be fun for people who know NetHack, who are, like, very familiar with the game. But for people who aren't familiar with it, I just think it would be extremely hard to follow what's going on. Be kind of like streaming Dwarf Fortress or something. Aw, soldier died. Oh well. I guess I did kind of let him get ganged up on there. Sorry, dude. Level 40, nice. That's what I'm looking for. Alright, I think this is the level where I need to go to the right. If I want to get on the same path that the boss is on. So I should hold on to my mana for now if I want to try to capture that guy. This lady really needs to stop blocking. I really like Dwarf Fortress LPs. Dwarf Fortress is amazing, especially since I'll never understand all the letters. Like, I like reading stories about Dwarf Fortress. So I guess if someone was like really good at describing what's happening in Dwarf Fortress, that would be a fun LP to watch. I don't know how good I would be at describing NetHack though, but I mean I could try. Worst thing that happens, you know, I do an LP that not many people watch. You know, that I've certainly done that before, so wouldn't be the end of the world. Yeah, that's true. Kasha mentioned that there's a tiled version of Dwarf Fortress that would make it easier to watch. And there's a tiled version of NetHack, too. But, I imagine it would still be pretty hard to follow. Alright, 3 health potions, full mana bar. I'm still feeling pretty good. Jeff Major and Arumba 07. I think I've watched some of Jeff Major's stuff before. Or I might be thinking of another Jeff. See if this dummy can get confused by this trap. I mean, I feel bad for that fireman, but I'm not going to stand on the freeze trap to try to hit those guys. Enemies do not handle traps very well. Oh, there you go. Crap, turn around. Damn it. I will admit the turning in this game takes a little getting used to. Because it's not just like an instant turn, there's like a frame of animation there. And I don't always compensate for that. I mean, I understand why they do it. Because... Oh no! I missed my chance to go right. That is really unfortunate. I thought I could have gone right further down. Oh well. Well, if I die, I'll get resurrected where that camp token is, and I'll have a chance to go right. So I hope I die, everyone. Cross your fingers. His dad's dying, so he hasn't uploaded in a long time. That sucks. Is that the same Jeff as 1F Jeff? Or is that another Jeff that spells his name with 1F? You can't go right in 2 floors. I can, but I will have already been gotten past the point with the boss. Because the boss was... By that time, the boss will have been a couple floors up. I thought I could make it. It is the same one. I thought so.
It was one of those damn spiders that got me. Just take this and go.
More money. More problems. What? How did that not hit her again? I guess she dodged. I should have been paying more attention to the map. The only thing I don't like about the roguelike community is how anal most of them are about the definition of a roguelike. Like, how picky do you have to be to call Dungeons of Dreadmore a roguelike because it has... Oh, to not call Dungeons of Dreadmore a roguelike because it has graphics. Yeah, people can be pretty snobbish about the term roguelike. I mean, the way I see it, any game that's played on a grid with one-to-one movement... Or, I mean, not any turn-based grid game, but like any randomly generated game with permadeath and one-to-one, you know, turn-based movement is roguelike. And games like Spelunky and Binding of Isaac are action roguelikes. I think that's a pretty good way to differentiate between the two. It's like the roguelike equivalent of an action RPG. Or just call it a roguelike, I don't care. Call it a game with roguelike elements. You know, whatever you want. I like the term procedural death labyrinth. Yeah, that's a pretty good one. It doesn't look like the stream's down. Justrop says he's having issues. You know, I've been streaming on Hitbox every now and then. It's just basically I'm playing a game and I don't talk or anything during those streams, but I just stream it out for the fun of it. And Hitbox seems to work pretty well. Like, I'm thinking of switching from Twitch to Hitbox for all of my streams. Like, it works surprisingly well for, like, a small startup competitor to Twitch. Yeah, see, if I go right, then it'll be too late for me to fight the boss in the level below me. Working again. Oh, okay, good. So, yeah, I don't know. Hitbox is pretty cool. Of course, I kind of like having just a separate channel for me to just stream out gameplay for if I don't feel like talking during a game. I mean, not that many people have watched that stuff, but you know, if something cool happens in a game, it's nice to like be able to have a record of that and like isolate the cool part and upload just that to YouTube. So what's the reason to go the difficult route as opposed to an easier route? Well, the difficult route is shorter. Like, the harder the route is, the fewer rooms you have. Like, I think if you take the middle route, you start out... Oops, wrong button. Oh well. If you take the middle route, you start out two rooms down in the dungeon. And if you take the rightmost route, you start four rooms down. I believe that's how it works. Oh, my inventory is full again. I think I'll drop this antidote and pick up this health potion. There have been a lot of health potions in the shopkeeper's inventories this run, which is a lot better than my Monday run was. You notice that occasionally when an enemy hits me, it says reflect. That's that it's an amulet that I picked up. It's pretty nice. Aw, man, she threw me out of my slide attack? How the heck? I thought I hit her with that. Well, I guess I can use my capture orb on pretty much anything now, since I won't be able to use it on the boss. It doesn't look like I'll be 45 by the time I'm done with this run, so I won't be able to capture the living creature. Ow. I forget what the difficulty of this room is. Seems pretty easy so far. Is there any reason to switch the route halfway through? Well, if you want to get to the boss or get to the City of Gold, then you might have to switch the route halfway through. Like, for example, if I had taken the right path in the room where I put the camp token, then I could have gone to the City of Gold and fought the boss. Or if I switched to the rightmost path, then I could have had two more arena rooms, and I could have fought talked to Paganini. So, I mean, most of the time you can just pick the easy route and just go straight down. But depending on what you want to do in a playthrough, there are reasons to switch routes. First time I've heard of Hitbox. Does it have the same delay issues Twitch does? I don't know. The Just Drop says the delay is shorter, but it's probably because less people use it. Yeah, that's definitely... definitely seems to be the case as far as the user base goes. I think some of Twitch's delay is intentional, though. I don't know, that's total hearsay. But I heard it rumored that they added intentional delay to the stream for some reason. What do we have here? Poison upgrade? Nah. I like Katrina a lot better than the monk. Like, she's faster, her abilities seem to combo into each other better. Of course, I don't have all of the monk's abilities yet. So, it's possible that he gets way better the more abilities you unlock. Nice, reflected that. Still got knocked on my ass though, but didn't take the damage for it. Dang it. Man, these witch ladies like to block a lot. Just noticed that enemy's boobs are out, yeah. This game is definitely fond of the boobage. Ooh, I should capture her. I don't have Nightmare Pinkoya yet. I am very close to death though, so I'm going to have to use a couple potions. Hey, stop cheesing that freaking move, you jerk. Oh, I hate Pinkoya. I mean, I like playing as her, but fighting against her is not fun. Just such a long range with that damn pole arm. I'm gonna go on ahead and pop my AoE. Oh, wow. I totally forgot I had a soul. What did I have? Oh, right, Stone Golem. Forgot about you, buddy. I will take Nightmare Pinkoya, though. She seems a lot slower than the real version of Pinkoya. But I guess all of the Nightmare versions of enemies are kind of like that. Aw, man. Bird person again? Game is like a bird person shooter. I mean, I can't shoot now, but there are characters who can shoot. So technically, and there are a lot of bird people in this game. Well, at least two. A bird person shooter. You're so funny, Duke. It's amazing that I haven't been offered a sitcom deal yet. I'm way funnier than the shit my dad says guy. Of course, I don't know who would play me in a sitcom. Definitely not someone of William Shatner's caliber. Oh, you really need to stop dodging. Jeez, I can't hit these people. Everything I do, they just dodge, dodge, dodge. Maybe I need to start throwing, but then, no, they dodge that too. Of course, I don't know how I throw people without arms. Alright, doing pretty good on health. It'd be nice if I can get through this without using a potion. Get a free heal out of it. Which I think I should be able to do. If I don't get corner cheesed. Phew! Frazier ain't got nothing on Duke. I don't know, man. I kinda like Frazier. The show. Not so much the person. Well, Frazier's okay, but Kelsey Grammer's kind of a jerk. The pointed mask was actually what doctors used to wear in the 1700s. Oh yeah, it's like a plague doctor mask, right? I guess that's more of a person in a mask than a bird person. But the peacock dude is actually a bird person. Oh no! That was a bad idea. See, you would think, oh man, this section looks terrible. I don't think I want to go over there. You would think, on those face statues, on the ones that move from left to right, you should be able to stand on top of them. Like this one, for example. I should be able to just stand on it, but that's not the way it works.
This is all I can do now. Kill any nearby monsters for me. Maybe I can go with some...
Bunch of gold. Nice. Thanks. Oh, I hate these faces so much. What? See, it's very confusing because with Pinkoya, the character that I have unlocked, she doesn't have that projectile attack for one, and this move on Nightmare Pinkoya, it's down and special, but I have it mapped to just special without a direction with real Pinkoya, so I have to get used to the different a different special mapping. And also, she's way slower than real Pinkoya. I just don't like the projectiles in this game. It just feels like they never hit. And of course I'm going to keep using them accidentally, because I mean to do this move, which is mapped to down and special. It's like a reference to Spelunky, yeah. At least these crushing blocks don't instantly kill you. There are no instant kills in this game, thankfully. I wonder how close I am to... Oh man, my mana meter is almost completely empty. Oh, at least my health is full with Catrian. I don't know why I'm having such issues killing those skulls. Fire resistance. What do I have? Curse resistance. I guess curse resistance is technically better. Also, real Pinkoya has a really great move where she, it's kind of like Catrian's infinite sword attack, except that she infinitely spins her pole arm. And Nightmare Pinkoya doesn't have that move. Yeah, great. Just bounce me back and forth. That's fair. Back to a character who's actually not frustrating to use. Alright, there's no reason, yeah. Can't even go left or right here. Ooh, nice! Maximum health vials, always a good sign. And one more moderate level before the boss. Oh my god, there's so many enemies here. Well, I guess there's not that many. I hate these skeletons. I cannot let the skeleton get a combo going, because if I do, I'm screwed. crap, I'm all out of cancel points. I'm gonna have to rest a little bit. Okay. Doesn't take long for the cancel points to come back. But, like, if you run out at an inopportune time, it's pretty easy to get yourself in trouble. Yeah, Catrian's awesome. I think she's my favorite of the three main playable characters. Oh hey, my mana meter's full again. Nice. See, that's what you get when you put all of your upgrade points into mana on your specials. You regenerate mana super quickly. So I should be able to get a pretty good enemy to help me fight the warlock. Definitely can. Not going to get any miracles with 70 XP though. Crap. I meant to get up on that platform, but it didn't work. Alright, I think this is it. Oh crap. I didn't capture an enemy. That's not good. I wonder if there are any areas of this level that I bypassed. I mean, I was waiting for a better enemy to capture, but if this was going to be it, then anything is better than nothing. Let me run back real quick and just see if there are any enemies at all back here. Oh, there's a chest I didn't... Ah, here we go. I can get this mummy. I mean, mummy's not great, but it's better than nothing. And I won't be able to capture the warlock, obviously. That's like, I have to be level 60 to capture him, I think. And even if the living creature does spawn, I'm not 45 yet, so... No reason to save my mana. Right. Yes, jump in the lava. Oh hey, it's the vomit mummy. Nice. I thought it was the fire mummy for some reason. I guess that fire sword the mummy's carrying around threw me off. Alright, here we go. It's warlock clobbering time. Theoretically. Oh, I should have switched back to Catrian, because she has like a little monologue. Oh well. Switch back to her and pick up these health orbs. Oh, I have a skill point to allocate, so put it on this other skill that I never use. Oops. That one, right, okay. And it always gives you one medium health vial before the boss, so I'm going ahead and use the one I have. Going into this with a mummy with full health and four health potions, I think I should be okay. Oh wait, another orb. Of course, it's just going to switch back to Catrian as soon as I drop down there, so might as well just stay in my human form. Actually, I don't.
This isn't our cabin anymore. You left my side.
I don't know what that means.
Be alone with your dark experiments. You aren't the man I knew.
I am your husband, Catrian. Until death parts us.
I definitely didn't know that.
But we were. departed. Or did you forget?
No! Away with you! Torment me no further.
This dude has, like, a journal. That's the collectible in this game. You find pages of the Warlock's journal. But I'm missing one page. And I haven't read any of it yet because I wanted to wait until I had the whole thing. Oh, hey. My vomit animation made me invulnerable to those fish. That was pretty nice. Alright, can't get cocky. Warlock is a tough fight. And the mummy is not very good. But I can get a few hits on him before Catrian takes over. Aw, come on! That was like the prime spot for vomiting on him. Oh jeez, come on! You jerk. On the block button. Man, he really likes that fish attack. Which, I mean, I don't blame him. It's a pretty good attack. But not very honorable to spam it all the time. Of course, I don't know why I'm expecting the Warlock to fight with honor. And pop a potion now so I don't die unexpectedly. Of course, if I do die, then I have that camp token set up so I could actually fight the mid boss. But then the stream would last like an hour longer. I don't know if you guys have that much patience. Aha, interrupted your fish attack. What are you going to do now? Oh, hit me with your gigantic hand, apparently. That's cool. I mean, if I had a gigantic hand, I'd probably be doing the same thing. Yes! Wow, that was a shitload of experience. Mummy is basically trash. Yeah, he kind of sucks. Although, you can trip up some of the stupider enemies with that vomit attack pretty easily. Well, that's been Abyss Odyssey. I have to say, the ending cinematic, quote-unquote, it's a little disappointing. I mean, they could have at least had voiceover for the ending text. So, once you beat the Warlock, It takes you to this place between worlds. This is also where you go if you die in the game. And there's a move you can pick up here, but I already got it. And if you want to play again, the map stays the same. So, theoretically, I could go back through the same dungeon and everything would be the same. I'd probably take the middle path just to make sure I don't forget to branch off and fight the boss. I think I'll do that, actually. This is Pinkoya, by the way. That's the infinite spin attack I alluded to. This is how I have her set up. Up and special is that. Special by itself is that. And then down and special is that. But just, like, the way her ass is pointed at the camera, even though it's a side view. Like, I don't know. I like Katrien a lot. Alright, so when you beat the Warlock, you keep your consumable items, unlike when you die, and you keep however much mana you had, and obviously you keep all your gold. I'm going to see if I can fight the living creature, because I hear that the living creature can drop the... Oh, there he is. He can drop the page of the manuscript that I need, or the page of the journal. And it's a shame, I actually have enough, or I will have enough mana to actually capture this guy, but I'm not high enough level yet. This is also a very difficult boss. I've only beaten him a couple times. And I usually have a summon when I do it. Of course, I can still use my AoE attack to do a bunch of damage to him. I just won't be able to catch him. I'm pretty sure it's 45, maybe? Let's double check. Yeah, it's 45. That's a shame. You... Ugh. Alright, I need to get out of this corner. You know, you could be helping me, dude. Okay, that's quite enough. Your big-ass lion with wings, I think you would have more impressive abilities than just spitting fireballs at me over and over again. I want to try to kill this guy just to see if he drops that journal page. Oh my god. This guy is definitely harder than the Warlock. Or maybe it's just because I haven't fought him enough times and I don't know how to deal with him yet. Cut it out.
I must find one of those altars.
Katrien? Alright, soldier. I don't have very high hopes for you. Wouldn't it be funny if I did way better with a soldier than I did with Katrien? I would pick up that reflect amulet, but it doesn't, its ability doesn't actually work for the soldiers. Nope. Man, that is a hard boss. If I had a summon, I might have been able to deal with him. So, I just lost my mana, which I used anyway, and I lost my health potions, which I also used anyway. And also, pretty sure the map is different now. Huh. Well, it is different, but it actually shows me where the boss is on this map. When you start the game out, it doesn't show you where the boss is. Huh. What time is it? 7:30? I can do one more run. If you guys want to watch. Duke must be the first person ever complaining about a woman's ass being there. I mean, it's not that I have a problem with women's asses in general. It's just, I don't know, it's just gratuitous, you know? It's unnecessary.
Greetings. I know I can't stop you from going down.
Alright, do I want to buy a better sword? Greetings. I mean, I still have a pretty good amount of money, so... I will prepare, and then I will do another run. This time the boss is in the left-hand column. So as long as I just keep going down, I will eventually meet my goal.
You can use the greetings.
I'll buy a cheap camp token. Oops. I was looking at the chat. Alright, see you later, Koss. Thanks for hanging out. Alright, so all I have to do is head left, which I should be able to do before the point where the boss shows up. It seems we've reached an impasse. Boy, they do not respond very well to your attacks. I think I'll buy a mana vial. I meant to buy a summon before I came down here, but I fell down the pit prematurely. Oh well. No key. Two locked chests and I haven't found a key yet. That's disappointing. Oh, there's one of them. Oh, there's two of them. Not very smart of you to keep both of those keys in the same area. And thanks to that mana potion I bought, my mana is already fully good. Very nice. No health potions, oh well. Alright, can I go left from here? I can. I'm going to go on ahead and do that. So I don't forget later. By the way, in case you were wondering, once you leave an area, you cannot go backwards. The path closes behind you. A lot of people have been calling this a Metroidvania, which I think is an even less accurate term for this game than roguelike. Because, I mean, Metroidvanias are all about, you know, having a huge area to explore, and they involve a lot of backtracking and opening up new areas that you couldn't get to before. Pretty much the only thing this game has in common with the Metroidvania is, like, the map style. Of course, that's another term that everyone gets really huffy about if you use it incorrectly. I mean, it's not a big deal if someone calls this a Metroidvania, it's just not accurate. I could get the Pudutar. Sure, why not? I mean, she's not great, but she's fun enough to use. She has a pretty long pole arm, which is nice. A cool kick attack. And it's just fun to play as a four-legged creature. She, you know, she controls a lot differently than the humanoids. I'm gonna go ahead and pop that mana potion. It's a Call of Duty, like, yes. It's a Doom clone. Oh yeah, forgot about that one. That's just a neutral special attack. You know, I bet getting kicked in the head by a deer would hurt a lot. Like, not as much as getting hit in the head by a horse, or kicked in the head by a horse. But it would still be pretty bad. Must be hard for a deer centaur to climb, or any kind of centaur. I mean, can you imagine the upper body strength it takes?
My sayings give wisdom to some, but not much of anything to others.
It sounds kind of like the Bastion narrator. Pretty sure it's not the same dude, but it's definitely evocative. I cannot hit this pot to save my life. You should stop hitting the pot, Duke. What's the Bastion narrator's name? I forget. It's been too long since I played that game. Okay, no hidden room there. Deers kind of jump at all times, so it's not as hard as it is for us. Yeah, I guess it's true. But still, I mean, imagine... I mean, it's hard for a human to grab onto a ledge and pull himself up. Just imagine if your lower body is like a huge deer body or a horse body. Well, that didn't work. That attack was not so special. But yeah, deers are pretty nimble and agile, so I guess a real-life Pudutar wouldn't have any trouble getting around. You know, I looked up the word Pudutar, and apparently that's a word invented for this game, because all of the references to a Pudutar on Google were pages about Abyss Odyssey. I figured it was like an actual, you know, the actual mythological deer equivalent of a centaur. But either the creature itself is made up or the name is just made up. I really don't like her neutral, normal attack. Very, like, that does not look very effective. That looks pretty effective, though. That's just forward and attack. It'd be awesome if her knees bend the opposite way. Yeah, then we'd be like satyrs. The goatman. Kinda surprised there are no goatmen in this game. Like, there's every other kind of animal hybrid you can imagine, but I have not seen any goatmen. Which, considering all the sort of satanic imagery, actually, I'm kind of glad that Nightmare Pinkoia doesn't have the same moves I have set up for her, because I wouldn't want to have to fight her if she had those moves. I mean, she's pretty formidable as it is. Why'd the music stop? That's weird. Aw, man. How the heck did she hit me when I was in the middle of that move? Well, I got a little cheesy there at the end, but at least I didn't lose my Pudutar. Servitars are the technical term for deer centaurs. Oh. I did not know that. Yeah. I guess Pudutar is just something they made up. Which is cool. I mean, this game doesn't have to be 100% accurate to real-life mythology. I mean, Paganini's in this game, for crying out loud. Yes. Man, I don't want any of this crap. I can get extra charm time, but I don't have a charm weapon. I can buy a sword that's worse than what I have. With level 2 fire or ice. Minus 75% curse time. I mean, that's useful, but I could buy a stone golem. But my mana is more than halfway full, so I should be able to capture another enemy pretty soon. I think I'll be okay. At least I killed the warlock. Feels good to actually have a successful run after Monday turned out pretty horribly. Ugh. Oh, great. My Pudutar got killed by a damn flower. And I got poisoned anyway. It's interesting that a deer centaur is a servitar, because doesn't cervix actually mean, like, neck? I mean, I know the cervix that a lady has, but I thought the cervi, C-E-R-V-I prefix, had something to do with the neck. Well, I could get a level 3 charm rapier. Oh wait, I don't have enough money for that. Dang. The charm weapons are really nice. They're a little overpowered, to be honest. Because, I mean, when you charm an enemy, it fights for you for like 30 seconds or a minute or something crazy like that. And, like, it distracts the other enemies, and it lets you, you know, lets you breathe. It's very nice to have a charm weapon. But usually the charm weapons you find in the game are less powerful than the starting sword in terms of damage. And the ones you can buy are very expensive. You know, it's really not fair to bring a gun to a sword fight. Especially a shotgun. See, this game has a shotgun. That means it's a Doom-like. In Latin, it doesn't mean neck. So I guess deer are like identified by having. See, you think a Servitar would be a half giraffe, half human, which would be really creepy looking, especially if it had like a giraffe-sized sized neck. I guess that's not how centaurs work, though. Like the human half is relatively normal, and then the horse half is just a normal horse. So it's not like a giraffe centaur would have an extremely long neck. Unless the human half was on the bottom and the giraffe half was on top. Oh, you know what? I should capture these guys. No. Phew! Well, I got my butt kicked, but I have a wood golem now. I don't think they knew about giraffes back then. Yes, that is a good point. Well, I don't know. I mean, the Roman Empire was on pretty good terms with, well, I was going to say they were on good terms with Egypt, but I don't think they have giraffes in Egypt. And I don't really know how much of the rest of the African continent they explored back then. Hey, Afrol, what's up? Alright, still on the right track, right? Yes! Only one difficult room, and then I fight the boss. Got 3 health potions, a healthy wood golem. Catrian's kind of hurting, but hopefully I'll go up a level and she'll get a little bit of health back. A poison sword, 12 damage. Is that, yeah, mine 16. So, nope. I said I don't want that sword. Thanks. Ooh. No, I said I don't want that sword. I will take this health potion though. Oh, inventory full. What do I have? Oh, camp token. That's right. All right. Let's pop back to Catrian and use one of these medium health potions. That was after establishing language. Yep, that is very true. And I imagine they would have discovered deer before they discovered giraffes. I bet when they saw the giraffe, they thought, dang it, why did we waste the neck name on the deer? Oh well. Wow, another secret door? There's secrets everywhere. See, I can get a charm weapon. I go from 16 damage to 11. But you know, I haven't shown off the charm yet, and the charm is really good, so I think I'll take it. It's free. Those red vine things poison you, by the way. Which is why I'm taking great pains to avoid them. No. I should have switched to Catrian for that part. Any skill points to spend? Nope. What you got? Okay, I will use one of my medium health vials, and I will buy another one. Could buy another wood golem if I wanted to, but there wouldn't be a reason to do that. I've been getting really into history due to Europa Universalis. Heard a lot of good things about that game, about that series. I tried playing Civilization for the first time recently. Like, I bought Civ 5 during a Steam sale forever ago, but I never actually played it. Aw, he didn't stay charmed very long at all. I guess level 1 charm isn't very good. And I went through the tutorial for Civ 5, and I st- still don't understand that game as well as I would like to, like even after the tutorial. Unfortunately, it wouldn't let me save my game during the tutorial, so like I had a game going, but I had to stop playing, so that was kind of a bummer. Like, I would have liked to save my progress in the tutorial and finish playing in the tutorial before I started a real game. Of course, the Civilization games don't have anything to do with real history. They, in the game I was playing, my civilization was ancient Japan, and, like, I was right next to, like, an ancient Mayan civilization. So, it's not, not historical at all, but it's kind of the same general type of game as Europa Universalis, at least I think, if that game is what I think it is. I got wrecked.
I held out as long as I could, but I just ran out of luck.
I did not enjoy Civ 5, it's not as good as 4. Yeah, the only reason I bought 5 was because it was the newest one, to be honest. Like, I didn't know anything about Civilization.
So tired.
Man, these guys have been giving me a lot of gold lately, which is not what I would prefer for them to drop. That's a good place to stand. Alright, gonna have to switch back to Catrian to make this jump, probably. Huh? There we go. Alright, I think we have a boss next. Nothing over here besides the exit, so I'm not going to waste a key going in there. Alright. It's an easy room too, so hopefully this boss shouldn't give me too much trouble. Of course, there's a whole level before you actually fight the boss, so hopefully I won't get my ass kicked too badly. My mana bar's already halfway full again, which is nice. Should be able to fill that up all the way before I even get to the king. Jesus. Wood golems are not the most agile creatures in the world. Believe it or not. I mean, you think a tree would be pretty agile. You jerks. Well, she sure showed me. I love the wood golem's throw. Just grabs him by the neck and slams him down on the ground. They are nothing to the wood golem. Alright, let's switch back to Catrian and build up some of my mana. Curse resistance. I don't have a ring, so I guess I might as well take it. I could use my camp token here. I think I will. Just in case I need another shot at the boss. Just started raining outside, so apologies if you can hear that. Anything over here? Nope. That was close. Nice, I turned. Oh crap. How did I trigger the boss already? Oh, the boss room is right below me. That's weird. And the wood golem is no longer charmed. I've never knocked enemies into the boss chamber before. That's a first. Go ahead and pop a potion. Just to be on the safe side. Get ready for the boss to spam that horse move a lot. He really likes that. Oh hey, the wood golem is still charmed. He's fighting the boss for me. That's cool. Alright, the last time I tried to capture the boss, I used my spell right away. And when I actually killed him, he didn't drop his soul. So I'm going to try getting his health down pretty far first. I'm not sure if that makes a difference or not. But I have to be careful not to kill him before I can use my capture ability. I have to make sure the soldier doesn't kill him either. Alright, a few more hits and I will try to pop this off. Like, I don't know if the capture thing wears off if you don't kill him fast enough. Or I'm not sure why it didn't work. But this time I think I have him. Yep, there it is. Achievement unlocked, Dream Master. Capture a level 40 enemy. Heck yeah! It's the first time I've ever played this guy. So, see what my specials are. I have that, which is pretty cool. I have like a stomping ability. And I have, that's the high special. That doesn't seem very special. And then normal, forward, high, low. This game looks like Trine. Yeah, a little bit. Doesn't really play anything like it though. Oh wait, I didn't see that health potion drop. Man, this guy has 4,700 hit points, that's insane. Ooh, skeleton guy. I mean, I'm not going to give up the king to play the skeleton, but it'd be fun to play as him for a little while. Unfortunately, I had to fight another skeleton. But I should be able to fill Catrian's health if I can get through this. Another skeleton! No fair. I'm only one skeleton. How do you expect me to fight two? Well, at least it's not at the same time. I do like the skeleton a lot. But I just can't give up playing as the king. I mean, it's good to be the king, you know? You jerk! Oh, it's just that guy. The Balta, or however you pronounce his name. Yep, I tried to throw him, but it did not work out. Oh, come on, don't make me use a health potion to get through this. Deltas are not supposed to be that hard to kill. I mean, their main projectile attack is throwing like a lamp at you. Or, no wait, I guess that's a dagger. But that's like the crappiest, least effective dagger I've ever seen. Oh, he froze me, but he hit me immediately. And if you hit someone, it unfreezes them. Man, I should be using that attack more often. The uppercut thing? It's a pretty good one. Especially comboing out of that one. Alright. I had to use a potion, but I guess it could be worse. I could have had to use two potions. As much as I would like to take the skeleton, I have to fight with this guy. God, he has so many hit points. That's awesome. All right, horse. You know what to do. Yeah. Fleur-de-lis. 15% chance to avoid an attack. That would actually be pretty helpful. I'll take it. I like how his sword is just kind of hovering in front of him. Like, it looks like the sword, like, follows his gaze. Like he controls the sword with his eyes. What's this guy's actual name? Verbum Dei. My Latin isn't good enough to figure that one out. Actually, doesn't Dei mean God? Something God? Verbum. I don't know. I'm trying to work backwards from English words that start with verb. V-E-R-B. But, I don't think it's... I don't think it's the verb that we're all thinking of. Well, they interrupted my horse attack. Having the sword in that position just makes it look like he has a very long, pointy beard. Kinda comical, actually. I stab you with my goatee. Weapon I can't use, no secret door. Only drawback to that horse attack is that it takes a pretty long time for him to actually come out. Alright. I guess I don't really have a reason to switch to the Pokura path. I can just keep going straight down. Roughly translate to Word of God. Oh, and it's just dropped. Not exactly what I think when I see this enemy, but that's a pretty cool name for an enemy. No! Alright, let's see if I can collect these coins. Nope, wrong button. Wrong button again, without getting hit. Anything else over here? No. Mana's about a quarter full. Don't have any fire attacks right now, do I? Nope. If there was an altar nearby, I could just get Katrigan's fireball attack temporarily, so I could open that up. That lunge attack is pretty powerful for being such a basic attack. Seems like it would be pretty easy to cheese the enemies with that. How many crowns does this guy have? It's either... looks like 6 or 5. Well, I guess technically he's wearing a crown on his head. And he has 6 floating above his head. That's pretty good. I'd say that's a number of crowns deserving of the title Word of God. It's more crowns than I have. Of course, I am just the Duke of the Bomb, so I guess it would be a little conceited of me to have 6 crowns.
My sayings give what goes around comes around.
200 XP, not bad. One of the higher quantities of XP you can get from that guy. No thanks. Alright, just one more level, and I'll be high enough to capture the living creature, if I can actually kill him. It would be really fun to fight as that thing.
Bienvenido.
No thanks. I just noticed that Verbum Dei is transparent. Or translucent, I guess. Like you can see a skeleton through his skin. That's kind of unsettling. Oh yeah, I still have my charm sword, so I don't want to give that up. Yep, I was correct. It is pretty easy to spam enemies with that attack. Reflect? Yep. 15% chance to dodge or 9% chance to reflect. I think I'll keep the higher percentage. Reflect is pretty nice, but I'd rather have a higher chance to not take damage. That is so cheap, oh my god. But I mean, if it's effective. Hey, thanks for hanging out while I kill that guy. That reminds me of like a Marvel vs. Capcom special move, or one of those Capcom vs. games. Like they always had these really elaborate special attacks where you summon just these gigantic characters to come on the screen and wreak havoc. It's kind of what the horse is. The only difference is I can do that with just one button, as opposed to Marvel vs. Capcom where you have to like build up a special meter and... there's some money over here. That's weird. Money just laying around on the ground. Another nice thing about this dude is that he's immune to being frozen. Because normally when you get hit with an icicle like I just did, it freezes you. But not Verbum Dei. Not the Word of God. It's getting kind of framey. That's a good move too. Down an attack. It's a good way to clear out some enemies that are on both sides of you. Okay, if you just want to stand there, I have no qualms with just stabbing you with the same move over and over again. Now, if I was fighting against another human, I'd have more honor than that, because nothing sucks more than being beaten in a fighting game by someone spamming the same move over and over again that prevents you from escaping it. Like, I remember specifically in Mortal Kombat 4, there was a character who had an ability that, where you, like, drop down the bottom of the screen and oh crap, my headphones came partially unplugged, I think. I'm only getting sound in one ear now. It's very disorienting. No, don't turn. Oh, well, I guess that works too. Yeah, I guess it doesn't actually matter which direction I'm facing. They'll get hit eventually. Gotta say, Verbum D, kinda broken. I mean, I guess it makes sense since there's only one place in the whole game where you can capture him. I wonder if you can actually buy his summon from the shop once you capture him. That would be kind of broken. Fix my headphones. Sorry about that. Oh hey, there's a boss on this level. Well, let me make sure I'm not missing anything before I drop down there. Because once you drop down into a boss area, there's no turning back. Oh yeah, that's right. Just a weapon I can't use, okay. I love how mad he looks when he's running too. Just like, grrr! I'm angry. I am an angry king. He kind of reminds me of a pirate with that long beard. Arr, I'm the word of God. Switch up your strategy, dude. Sorry, no mercy against AI. That's always been the rule. You can cheese a computer, but don't cheese your friends. Now, if this was Primal Rage, then it would flash a no cheese icon on the screen and it would not allow me to do that. What? I don't know why that attack did not hit that skull. I mean, I guess capturing the king isn't the easiest thing in the world, so you kind of deserve to have the opportunity to cheese a little bit. Oh hey, I hit 45. I didn't notice. I can definitely capture the living creature now. If I can defeat him. Of course, I already got the Chivo. This dude is retribution. Exactly, just dropped. This is revenge for all the times the computer cheesed the heck out of me. What? Why can't I? That does not make any sense. Why can't I land on this platform? Must be a glitch of some kind. Yep, I just fall right through it. I guess it's freaking out because it doesn't know how to handle a character that's this tall. Do I have any skill points to distribute? I do. I mean, not that I'm going to use any of these other attacks. Okay, that's maxed out, so I guess I'll put that into the fireball. This is what the fireball looks like, by the way. I mean, it's fine, it's just not as useful as the other attacks. And then I could also get... Oh wait. I could also get this one. And I have no idea what this does. It doesn't look like it's an attack at all. I mean, maybe some kind of counter or something? I don't know, whatever it is, I've never been able to effectively use it against an enemy, so I'll stick with good old infinite swords. Stat, nice. Yep, that platform is just permanently glitched. Aw, I was hoping the horse would spawn on the lower level. I guess that's too much to ask for. I like the golden calf because he has laser eyes. I should switch back to Catrian so I can actually get through this without getting hit, maybe. There we go. Well, Verbum Day is almost dead, but I've definitely got my money's worth out of him. He is a cool character to use. Alright, how close am I to the boss? Oh cool, only two more rooms. This is going quicker than I expected. Really? A mummy and a soldier. Nice. He spawned on the upper level but still hit the lower level. Oh, did he? I did not notice that. Okay, no secret. Could be useful against the last boss, yeah. Unfortunately, he probably won't be alive by the time I get there. I guess I could switch back to Catrian for a little while. I can go after the boss with the broken character. Oop! Aw, man. Is it worth fighting a skeleton to get a crate and a pot? Hey, I charmed this guy. That means I am free to abuse him all I want. I mean, I would feel pretty bad about that, but he is an undead skeleton. Try something. It did still hit them. That is awesome. I mean, it makes no sense, but it's pretty cool. Is it not working because they're blocking, or is it just not working anymore? Oh, no, it still works. Nice. I guess they were just blocking slash dodging. Which, I mean, I don't blame them. If I had repeated horses being summoned against me, I would do the same thing. Feel kind of bad about that, but not really. Nope. Nope. Yep. Oh, well, it was nice while it lasted. Alright, I'm going to hold on to my mana, just in case I can beat the warlock and fight the living creature. Because I would like to fill out my roster if at all possible. Not that I plan on playing this game like competitively, but you know, just for completion's sake. There's no achievement for it or anything, but you know, I like having. I like having question marks filled in. Man, I took a lot of damage with Catrien. Didn't she have full health just a little bit ago?
I will avenge you, Catrien.
You've got to be kidding me. That was complete bullshit. Did it not drop any of her items? I guess not. Well, isn't that a fine kettle of fish? I forget if there was an altar on this level or not. Oh, here it is. That's pretty convenient.
I'm in your debt for bringing me back. The warlock's mind is trying to banish us. But
this helps our cause. Yeah, I've seen this dialogue a bunch already. Alright, well, I lost my items, which kind of sucks, but I would have had to use I would have had to use my potion anyway to stay alive, so I lost my my reflect amulet. Or my reflect bracelet, whatever it was. But I have full health now at least, so. I'm in pretty good shape. Wow, two chests in this room. Very nice. Wish I could sell these damn antidote potions. Well, I want to get my mana back up. So I'll buy that. And I'll buy a stone golem just to help me with the boss. That's a lot of money, but I think it'll be worth it. Aren't I charming? Seems like the charm always happens when I'm only fighting one enemy, and it doesn't do me any damn good. God, this guy has a lot of hit points. I just hit him with my sword like a billion times. Hey, buddy.
I say, he who kills by the sword dies by the sword.
That is often the case. Except for Genghis Khan. He died peacefully in his bed out of old age, surrounded by friends and family members. He definitely did not die of the sword. You are some pieces of shit. You fucking assholes. Stop it. Actually, I think technically it's supposed to be pronounced Genghis. And most people just say it wrong. But I'll probably always say Genghis. Actually, it's like Genghis or Genghis or something like that. Aw, man. I should not have walked over here. I should have just gone down to fight the boss. Because all that's here is a mana potion and a pot. And I have to fight two damn there's a spear that I can't use. Oh boy, 3 antidotes. Let me tell you how excited I am about that. You can probably tell by the inflection of my voice how thrilled I am about having 3 antidotes. Oops, forgot to switch back to Catrian. Oh well. It's not a very impressive soliloquy.
Give up and let me...
Oh, there's a new dialogue.
Just as in life, you betray me even now, siding with strangers.
I never betrayed you.
I saw you leave. The night you denounced me to the priest.
I had no choice. Your experiments were horrifying. But I didn't denounce you. I was seeking advice.
The advice of one who would damn my soul to hell for all eternity.
He isn't your enemy. You are in control of where your soul will reside upon your death.
They fear my talent. They would have me burned alive to sate their envy.
Oops. I wish I still had the Word of God here, but I guess Stone Golem will have to do. Even though I think he's going to be monstrously slow. Way too slow to be helpful. Yep. To be helpful against the Warlock. Just went ahead and pop my potion so I don't forget. I guess he's resistant to being charmed. That makes sense. You dick. Why? I did not mean to slide that way. I meant to slide in the other direction. I mean, I could pop my AoE. I mean, I can't capture him, but I could deal a lot of damage to him. Unfortunately, it looks like I might have to. I did not get to this guy with very many resources this time. I have to say, this guy is not very impressive. I mean, just in terms of what he looks like and what he does. I mean, he's wearing a cranberry bush on his head. She's gone. And he throws fish at you. Throws fish at you a lot. Like, fish is kind of his main thing. Maybe I can cheese him with my gun. Don't make me shoot you with this gun that I have. Officer Gunhaver. You know, I don't actually know how you would capture this boss, because it takes control away from you as soon as he dies, so you won't have time to pick up the soul. Interesting. I guess it has some special allowance for that, because I know you can capture this guy if you're high enough level. I have to say, Officer Gunhaver is surviving a lot longer than I thought he would. I wish I had Officer Shotgunhaver. That would be a much better ally for me right now. Of course, the Spear Officer is the best, because he has a long-ass pole arm and he has grenades. But only Pinkoya gets that guy. Yeah, I am not anywhere close to killing him. I'm putting up a pretty decent fight, though. Hey, I will cheese you with my gun all day long. Well, I did drop a camp token. Time is 8:30. I guess I can keep going. Of course, I lost all my good stuff. I have a chance to get Verbum Day again. Maybe I can actually bring him to the bosses this time. That'd be pretty cool. Well, that didn't work out the way I expected it to. Kinda wish this game had a quick save. Or I kinda wish all roguelikes had a quick save, actually. Because, I mean, not like a hit F5 and it saves kinda quick save, but like a temporary suspend save. Like, you shouldn't be able to actually save your game, because that's kind of anti-roguelike, but oh wait, I don't have enough mana to capture him. I might be able to get enough if I use enough special moves. Like NetHack. I mean, you can't actually save your game in NetHack, but you can, you know, quit and make a temporary save and then come back in. Not all roguelikes need a suspend, but runs can take a pretty long time in this game, especially if you use a camp token and respawn a bunch of times. So it would be nice to have. Dang it. Okay, dude. Enough of the horse already. Why don't you stab me with your goatee some? This game is kind of a butthole. Yeah, kind of. But I still really like it. The combat is just really fun. I don't think I'm going to be able to build up enough mana to capture him. Getting close. I think he's going to die before I have enough, though. Well, I don't know. He still has about a third of his health. Hey. That was rude. Dang it. I was hoping to knock him out of his horse attack. Oh my god. This guy might actually kill me. I can just get enough mana. I can take him out with my AoE. Come on, Catrian, you can do it. Oh, he's almost dead. Nope. Isn't gonna work. I wonder if I build up mana with a special attack even if he blocks. Dang it. Nope. Oh well. Oh yeah, that's right. It's one of these. I don't like this lady. I mean, she is pretty fast, which is nice, I guess. But her abilities aren't really that great. And she has like that very, very small ranged attack where she like spits on them. Of course, she also has that, which is just a normal attack. Sometimes the enemy's normal attack is better than their specials. Kind of counterintuitive. Would be very nice to get a full heal for Catran, though. So I won't complain about having one of these. See, look at this shit. Normal attack, special attack. Normal, special. Normal is way better. It's a punch and a spit. Sorry for the cheese. I almost forgot my soul. I mean, not that she's that great. Who is this anyway? The Sea Witch. And she's not great, but it's still, you know, another full health bar.
I can't believe I volunteered. How was I supposed to defeat a statue? A giant made of rock. I have this. It's better you take.
More treasure. Jeez. You know, don't give me a healing potion or anything. God forbid you give me something useful. I don't have any fire stuff, do I? No. No, her acid spit or whatever will melt the ice. I hiccuped, excuse me. Like, her special attack with the spit doesn't really combo with anything. That's a pretty good combo, though. Dive forward and then... and then do a little pirouette. I keep seeing the track that metal blade is attached to and thinking it's some kind of conveyor belt that I can stand on. Looks a lot like a conveyor belt until you look closely. Well, Sometimes you use your double jump when you don't expect to. Curse resistance? Meh. I mean, I could swap one of my attacks out for the fireball and go melt that ice, but it's not worth the time it takes to backtrack, really. For as much as I thought I didn't like the Sea Witch, I'm doing okay with her. Alright. How far away am I? Oh boy, I still have a ways to go. Slightly better sword than what I had. When you respawn at a checkpoint, by the way, you go back to, like, the basic default sword. Like, even if you buy a sword on the surface, one of the non-magical swords, you still respawn with just the basic sword. Just kind of a bummer. I guess you deserve it, though, if you die and have to respawn. Nope, I will stick with my poison sword, thanks. I guess the Sea Witch is better than I thought she was. I guess I didn't use her enough to really get an idea of her abilities. $250, nice. I would say don't step on any critter's tails. Even if it's a critter you know very well. That's just kind of a jerk move. I mean, I wouldn't step on a cat's tail. Who would do that? You know, cats are no better than almost any animal. I've had more pet cats in my life than any other animal. Not that I've had many pets in general, but... I guess technically I own more... or I didn't own them, but my family had more birds than cats overall. But just because my mom bred cockatiels for a little while, so we had several cockatiel chicks at one time. But I don't think those really count as pets. I leveled up by killing a fish. Actually, maybe we did have more actual pet cockatiels than cats. Because we really didn't have very many cats. I've had a lot of friends with cats that I've sort of interacted with. Not my pets, but just cats I was familiar with. Not really a cat person or a dog person. Like, I don't really differentiate. I like both, and I like cockatiels. I mean, if I had the choice to own one or the other, I would probably own a cat, just because they're lower maintenance than dogs, but I like dogs a lot too. Alright, see you later, Misty Shade. Thanks for hanging out. Still no fire weapon. I'm playing this a lot longer than I planned to. Hope you guys aren't getting bored. But, you know, I'm having fun just playing and narrating my experience. I'm probably not talking as much as I usually do, just because the stream is going on so long. So, I don't know how entertaining this is for people. But I'm having fun, and that's all that matters, dang it. Hopefully you're having fun too. I do think I'm playing better than I was when I started the session. You know, knock on wood. Oh yeah, that's right, I have a poison sword. I barely played as Catrian since I resurrected. Alright, I don't want to waste my mana on that guy. Hopefully I'll get an ice golem. Ice golems are pretty good. I don't know what monsters I still need to capture. I need to look at my monster list and then look up a roster and see what I'm missing. Because I have all the mini bosses down. Excuse me. I have the... Ooh, Ring of Avarice. That would have been more helpful earlier in the dungeon. Increasing my total gold gain. But yeah, I really need to figure out what I'm missing. Like, I think I'm missing one of those bowl. This might be the bowl I don't have yet. Let me try, because that's an ice golem too. I don't remember if I've captured both of these or not. Nice. So let's see, what does the ice golem have? Okay, I think I've gotten this guy before, because I remember, like, the frost breath. Alright, what about Bully? I have, like, a headbutt that could not butt that fish. Shouldn't these guys be immune to being frozen, since they're ice creatures? Well, I guess this guy's not technically an ice creature. What is he? Oh, Kamahukto. I'm saying that completely wrong, I'm sure. I think I captured this before because I'm pretty sure it was available in the shop. And I think the only ones available in the shop are ones that you capture. Or ones that you have captured at some point. But I'll stick with the bull because I haven't really been a bull during these videos yet. I don't really like them that much. They're hard to control. They're big and bulky and very, very easy to get ganged up on when you have such a huge hitbox. Just a normal ass 16 damage sword. I think I'll stick with my 12 damage poison sword. That's weird. You don't see non-magical weapons in the dungeon very often. I do have that roll attack though, which is very nice. Why is that fish just floating there? Like, look at how long it takes for the bull to turn around. It's kind of ridiculous. Ugh. It is fun playing as a four-legged creature, though, just because you don't do that in very many games. You know, when I was setting up the stream on Twitch, for some reason, Abyss Odyssey wasn't in the list of games. Which is kind of a bummer. So if anyone's looking for like a stream of Abyss Odyssey on Twitch, they're not going to find my stream. I don't know why it's not in the database yet. I mean, this game's been out for like 2 weeks now. I think. Or maybe it's closer to a week and a half, but still. At one point, I know that Twitch was using the Giant Bomb Games database, but they must not be using that anymore because Giant Bomb definitely has this game in their database because they did a quick look of it. So, I'm not sure why it's not in there yet. Oh, come on. I totally rolled over her. Alright, well, still have nearly full health with Katrien, which is pretty good.
I'm glad you found me before the monsters did.
Looks like they already found you, dude.
The shopkeeper. He's vicious. Don't underestimate him. I managed to take
good advice. You took a gold trophy from the shopkeeper? You couldn't have taken something more useful than that? Man, I'm not doing too good on supplies. Starting to worry a little bit about the fate of this run. I mean, I got the level 40 capture achievement, which is really what I was going for in this playthrough, but would be nice to get another warlock kill. So after this, the only achievements I have left are are getting all three, or yeah, equipping the monk with three fully powered up abilities, which is what I was going for on Monday, but I didn't gain nearly enough levels. And doing a nightmare run, which I don't know if I have what it takes to do a nightmare run or not. I mean, I watched someone do a nightmare run and it doesn't seem impossible, but it still seems pretty damn difficult. Poison, you jerk. Oh, he resisted my poison. That's not nice again. Wait, I do still have a poison sword, don't I? Yeah, Snake Fang. It doesn't look much different from a normal sword. Like, it doesn't have a green glow or anything. Oh, my mana's almost full again. That's cool. That was close. Ow. This is a bad place to fight. Right underneath one of those giant stone things. Of course, if I could knock him into it, that would be pretty cool. Oh, mana's full. Sweet. I should probably not save it for the living creature. Because at this point, I don't even think I'll be able to kill the warlock without some sort of assistance. Some sort of otherworldly assistance. Man, I don't want to capture these guys. Can't you give me like a stone golem or something? That'd be helpful. Just an undead firefighter, jeez. Come on, game, you wuss. Give me something worth fighting. I mean, come on. I should probably shut my mouth. He died of poison. For crying out loud. Yeah, no secret wall. No secret door, rather. That was a fancy chest opening. That was pretty good. I clicked in the stick and hit down on it at the same time. Apparently, using the stick to attack is one of the options in Super Smash Bros. Melee or Brawl, whichever one was on the GameCube. You could use the C-stick. So instead of like hitting forward and attack, you can just press the C-stick in that direction. And it's the same way in this game. See, I can use a stick, or I can use square at a direction with the other stick. So, I don't know, I mean, I guess maybe if you get good at using the stick, technically it's a little faster than using the button. I don't know though, it kind of hurts my brain thinking about playing the game that way. Is there an enemy down here? Yes, of course. But there's... is that a locked chest? I can't tell from here. Oh well. I can take on this guy. It's just one spear guy. Yeah, it's locked. Well, maybe the key is nearby. Well, I can't use that move here. I mean, I can if I'm very careful about it. Stop hitting me in the face. Or any other part of my body. Especially not the face, though. The face is the worst option available. God, it's just giving me these undead dudes. I don't want to waste mana on these guys. Of course, I'm going to die pretty soon if I don't do something. I do have one potion. I think I want to go on ahead and use it. I wish the enemies had friendly fire. There we go, a jackal. That's worth spending some mana on. Doesn't usually take when the first time I try to use the capture ability. I usually have to try at least a couple times to get it. I'll beat this guy just long enough to kill the jackal, so I don't take more damage than necessary with Catrian. I really don't like the undead fireman. God, what is that? What? That is the shittiest ability I've ever seen. I mean, that forward axe attack is pretty good. Oh, I really, really dislike jackals, especially when they have poison swords. Like, the way he's holding this axe is the dumbest thing I've ever seen. God, what? Wow. Oh no, he's not glowing blue anymore. I guess there is a time limit on that. This isn't looking good. I wasted my mana. I'm almost dead. I don't have any health potions. These guys are kicking my ass. Seems like none of the shopkeepers had health potions this time around. Once again. It's like a repeat of Monday's run. I still need like 2,000 more experience to level up, so I'm not going to get a heal from that anytime soon. I don't think you're going to slay the warlock, buddy, because one of your friends tried that, and it did not work out very well. I wonder if the sword that dropped is better than mine. I didn't really check it. No, 10 level 1, 12 level 2. Wonder what happens if you talk to this guy with a soldier. My sins. Oh, I guess he can. Where you find an old man, you will always find good advice. Ooh, 500 XP. Well, I was going to argue with that, but for 500 XP, I will agree with you till the cows come home. Oh, I got a gold key. I guess I can go get that chest. Well, there's an altar over here. I'll go ahead and do that first. Man, this is just like last game. I died right before that altar, and then I respawned right before I fought the boss. Oh wait, I still have one more room before the boss. Alright, let's go get that chest, because there might be a health potion in it, and I need every... Holy crap, this one can go side to side and up and down? I guess that's why it's a different color than the other ones. Wow, what a pain in the tuchus. I didn't realize there were ones that could go in all four cardinal directions. The ones that can only move on one axis are annoying enough. Already killed that guy, right? Sake. No health potion. Man, the game is being really stingy with them this time. Like, I've hardly found any. Either in the environment or available to buy. You have any more advice for me? No, that was the other guy. He didn't give me any advice. He gave that soldier dude advice. Level 48, though. That's pretty good. I think the level cap is 60. Because that's what the warlock is, I believe. God, I just respawned and I've already taken 500 points of damage. Almost 600. Why aren't my special moves chaining? I have three cancel points. Or I had them. There we go. That's what I've been trying to do. Didn't work again. I guess my timing was just off. This is a tough game. Like, a lot of people complain that this game is too easy, but they are way better than I am. And of course, I have an item altar instead of a normal altar, so I won't be able to revive here. Probably going to have to wait until the next level. Curse sword, level 8? No thanks. Wait, there's a chest over here.
I can't continue. I didn't have an antidote vial left to fight the poison. I'm a goner. But you can use this and continue to fight.
No healing potions. Maybe the game's balanced so it doesn't give you very many healing potions if you respawn or something. Maybe it's like, okay, this is your second chance. We're not going to be as nice to you this time. I don't know, but even before I respawn, well, yeah, it did give me a few health potions on my first attempt. Oh no. You stupid... I am getting really mad at these skulls. They remind me of the Lost Souls in Doom, just kind of... Oh my god! That's the most annoying enemy in the game. You can't fucking hit it. Alright, well, this has been Abyss Odyssey. Hope you guys enjoyed watching. Sorry, my second run didn't go so well. I did capture the Word of God, though. Stony page 9. Then I'll have the complete journal. Let's take a look at my roster and see if I can figure out what I'm missing. See, I'm still missing a ton of stuff. Right here are the 3 nightmare mode characters. I got those. I got the ice golem. I got the shopkeeper. That's a Keiko. I got the jackal. I got the soldier, officer, and firefighter. There's Verbum D. Stone golem. I'm trying to tell what those creatures are by the silhouettes. See, this one between these two is the bull that I think I'm missing. I have the golden calf and Camahueto, but I don't know what bull this is, if that is a bull. And I can't tell what this is either. I don't know what that is. That looks like the one in the top right corner looks almost like the bird creature, the Voladora. Like, that looks more like a real plague doctor mask, so I don't know what that is. Oh well, this has been Abyss Odyssey. I hope you guys have had fun watching. I have 2 more achievements left to get. I might try to do nightmare mode, I'm not sure. It's probably going to be quite a struggle, but I look forward to playing more of this game. This game's really fun. Thanks everyone for watching. I love each and every one of you. And I will hopefully see you guys soon. Bye, everyone.